What's up, YouTube? My name is Doc, and today I want to talk about five stocks that I think you should buy to make a little bit of money. That's under $10. So without further ado, let's cue the cannons for Market Monday. So getting right into it, I want to say that this is more so for beginner investors. If you're like me, you download the app and you got your free stocks from Robinhood or Webull, or you download a different app, you didn't necessarily know where to go from there. If you looked at stocks that are really cool, like your Nikes and your Starbucks and your Apples, those are above $100. So with that being a little intimidating, I decided to go with five stocks that I believe that are not as intimidating to get into the market that are under $10 that can help you understand like the way that the market goes. You may hold them for a while, you may hold them for years. I definitely bought a couple of these stocks myself. So without further ado, stock number one is SiriXM. Now, if you're in your 30s like me, you may have heard of SiriXM growing up. They were some of the first ones when it came to broadcasting on a broader scale outside of just FM and AM radio. Some of you may have never heard of that, but it was a thing. So before Spotify and Apple Music, there was SiriXM, and that was seen as kind of the next step past FM and AM radio. So if you're looking for a stock that has a little bit of branding for itself, this is definitely the stock that you may look into. Trading at about $6.31 as a market close on Monday, this is well below that $10 threshold that we've been talking about. And they do give a dividend every 3 months of a whopping 1 cent. I know it's not much, but if you're thinking about getting into dividend investing, this is a great entry point when you're getting ready to learn about getting paid for holding the stock and also watching stocks grow. So according to the analyst at Yahoo, it is at a near fair value, and also at tip ranking, it has it as a strong buy. And if you're cheap like me, you may not have Apple Music or Spotify. I generally like to listen to my Alexa or Pandora, and SiriXM owns Pandora. So seeing the success that Apple Music and Spotify has had, you can see that SiriXM can have some of the same success as long as they put the right efforts in. Stock number two is Kinross Gold Corporation. And if you ever want to own gold, this is the stock for you. Their sector is basic material, and of course their subsector is gold. Trading at $7.49, this is definitely a stock that you can look into when you're buying stocks in a very volatile market. So to not get too much into the weeds, back in the day, we used to use gold to buy and sell things, but then money came along and we could print it, and we would use this piece of paper to say that, hey, this is $100 worth of gold. Well, nowadays we kind of went away from the gold standard and we're just printing off money, and we're just kind of using this kind of trust system. So in the event that the dollar does crash, gold still kind of holds its properties as far as being able to buy and sell things. So gold generally does well when the market is volatile as it is nowadays. Yahoo ranks it as a near fair value, and Tip Ranking ranks it as a strong buy. So if you're not feeling that gold stock and you're like, you want to think about a different gold stock, here's another one. Stock number three, which is B2 Gold. Like we said with the last stock, it is in the basic material sector, subsection gold. It is currently trading at $5.65. Yahoo is ranking it as undervalued. And when stocks are undervalued, it's a great opportunity to get a position in that holding, which Tip Ranking has it ranked as a strong buy. So when it comes to having a portfolio, having good stocks that are going to hold their value and have the opportunity to grow over time, this is a stock to definitely look into. And as I said earlier with Siri, this is also a dividend paying stock. It pays a whopping 4 cents every 3 months. And I know, like I said, it doesn't seem like a lot, but over time that money can compound, enable you to buy more stocks, or just get you in the mindset of understanding what it means to hold stocks and grow dividends over time. Okay, now you got three stocks under your belt. Now we're going to move on to stock number four, and I can't take all the credit for this one, but this stock is called Shift Technologies Incorporated. So I definitely got to give credit where credit is due. I first heard of this stock through Meet Kevin. So if you want to learn more about this stock, check out this overview of Shift, and also stay a while and check out his other videos. I learned a lot from when he gets into real estate investing and stimulus checks and all types of things. So he's a great resource when it comes to that. And then the most important part is, what is it trading for? It is currently trading at $9.14. So just to give you a little bit of what the stock is, it's more of like an internet retailer. So if we ever been in an opportunity where we bought a car, it's very intimidating to go to a car lot, see all these different cars, and then try to decide which car you want. And not only that, have to negotiate it with a salesman. Shift is similar to Carvana, where you can just go online, look at the different cars, and decide which car you want from there. And then you have the opportunity to buy it and then have it delivered to your home. Right now, Yahoo has it rated as an overvalued stock, And generally, when it comes to stocks kind of getting the hype and people buying it before it becomes profitable. So when you look at other stocks like my favorite Tesla, it is generally called an overvalued stock, but because people want to get in before it becomes profitable, that's generally how people try to make their money, by anticipating the growth of a company. So that may already be priced into this. And then Tip Ranking has it considered as a moderate buy. And also, side note, when you go to buy some of these companies, look at their competitors and see how they are being priced. So when it comes to this stock, you want to look at Shift versus Carvana and any other stocks that may look into vehicle retail. And last but not least, my fifth stock is called Del Taco, ticker symbol TACO, Taco. Who doesn't love tacos? I love tacos. And if you never heard of this company, it's basically like a Taco Bell, but in my mind, it's more of like in the middleman of a Taco Bell and then a Chipotle, where Chipotle is more of fresh and then Taco Bell is more of like the cheaper route. So they meet right there in the middle when they're like cheap and fresh. So you can go to Chipotle and buy you a burrito bowl for $10, or you can buy this stock for $9.29. Doing research on these stocks, this is a stock that stuck out the most to me. I really dig this stock. I think it's a great opportunity to get into a stock that can ride the wave of the Chipotle wave, because they are trading at astronomical levels. Although Yahoo is ranking it at a overvalued stock and Tip Ranking has it as a moderate buy, looking at their balance sheet, their total assets are way higher than their total liabilities. And that's something I look for when I'm looking into stocks. I definitely look at a company, if they have more money than the money that they owe, it is definitely a company has opportunity to expand more and do more with their company, as opposed to other ones who are in debt, who are trying to catch up, like a lot of our car manufacturer companies out there. So there's a trend in restaurant industries where they are moving more towards having more vegan options. And of that, Beyond Meat is becoming more and more prevalent in this industry, where Del Taco has decided to partner with Beyond Meat to offer more menu items. And that is indicating to me that they're becoming more and more innovative as time goes on. Now, granted, we are in a volatile market right now when it comes to all the different things that are going on, and definitely not knowing what the future is going to hold, but that's generally what investing is. It is taking the time to look at different stocks and say, this is a stock that has opportunity to be better in the future than it is now. It is not necessarily buying a stock just to buy it. It is hoping that it's going to go up in the future. So all in all, these are the five stocks I think you should invest in, especially as a beginner investor. It kind of teaches you the different things about the stock market, how some things go up, some things go down. But generally, the whole point is to get you more comfortable in the stock market. And even if you've been investing for a while, these are great stocks to look into. I'm definitely going to be buying some after this video. So with that being said, thank you so much for watching. Let me know down in the comments what stocks you're going to think about investing in. And please pay me in that sweet, sweet currency I call the like button. It definitely helps my channel out. And always remember, I am not a financial advisor. I'm just a guy with a camera in a spare bedroom. He calls a YouTube channel, YouTube studio. Dang. And do your own research, because I'm not a financial advisor, but I am your financial friend. And if you want to support the channel further, please hit that subscribe button. It definitely helps out the channel. Thank you so much for watching, and see you guys next time. Whew. Oh yeah, we got to cue those cannons. Cue the cannons! Bah, 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 bah.